There is a God in heaven who hears all of our prayers. Oh, there is a God in heaven who answers all of our prayers. When you call, keep calling him, he will answer you. Oh, hallelujah. Yupo Mungu mbinguni asikiae maombi yetu. Oh, yupo Mungu mbinguni ayajibuye maombi yetu. Oh, Baba, tunapoomba
kwa shangwe tumsifu
comes our way is a holy man of God. Let us make a small room on the roof and put in it a bed and a table, a chair and a lamp for him. Then he can stay there wherever he comes to us. That is the word of the Lord.
Praise be to God, church. Amen. Praise be to God again.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
And God is good. Amen. My name this morning, I'm Willie Charles. Before to God, Christ is Lord and Savior. I'll take us through to the second reading, and I hope you're going to be blessed. It is found in the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 7. 2 Corinthians, chapter 7. We're going to start from verse 1 up to 4. Therefore, since we have these promises, dear friends, let us purify ourselves from everything that contaminates body and spirit, perfecting holiness and reverence of God. Make room for us in your heart. We have wronged no one. We have corrupted no one. We have exploited no one. I do not say this to condemn you. I have said before that you have such a place in our hearts that we would live or die with you. For and last, I have spoken to you with great and frankness. I take pride in you. I'm greatly encouraged in all our troubles. May joy knows no bound. Praise be to God.
Five of them. Number one,
Proverbs, that one and verse 17. A woman is a worker. A woman is a worker. You cannot bring life when you are not working. You cannot bring life when you are a beggar in your own home, or to your children, or to your husband. By the way, I always tell people, when you borrow someone, even money for offering, that blessing, you are only escorting that person to be blessed. You are talking music, yeah. But that is the truth of the matter. If you ask me, you know, sometimes I came to realize that's why men, we don't sit close with our wives at church, because every time they tell you, give me your offering. Let me tell you, you may think you are taking it for granted that we are sitting together now, I give you sadaka, but that is my blessing. You are only escorting me to the altar to receive the blessing. So be a worker to have your own money. Be a worker to support the work of God. Be a worker for your home to be tidy. Be a worker for your children to look smart. Be a worker for your husband to be respected. Be a worker. Praise be to God. Amen. Number two, a woman is a warrior. Give us Judges 5, 7. And villagers in Israel would not fight. They held back until I, Deborah, this is a woman speaking, until I, Deborah, arose, until I arose, a mother in Israel. She was a warrior. When no one was willing to fight, when everyone held back, she arose as a mother. And I want to tell you, women, this morning, because it is your day, for you to bring forth life, you must start as a warrior. Who are not your mama? You don't have to tell your children every time, let your dad come. Your dad is not a lion. Your dad is not a KDF. Don't scare your children by telling them, let your dad come, and you are going to see dust. No. You work as a warrior. Let them know you have authority. Let them know you stand your ground. Be a warrior to fight for your husband, to fight for your family, to fight for your right. Stand firm and fight. When women stand in this nation, we saw the Chagas and other Bruce coming to an end. Why? Because women are powerful. If at all, they can know and declare that we are going to be warriors and not naive. Praise be to God. Amen. Number three, a woman is a witnesser. Give us John chapter 4, verse 29. The Bible says when she met Jesus, she went and witnessed. And that's where we got our song, come and see what the Lord has done. Come and see the man who has told me everything, because she was a witnesser. And by the way, Jesus did not need microphones or posters or crusades to reach the whole village of Sychar, because a single woman did it. Amen. I came to realize some of the men that do not come to church, it is because of bad witnessing from our women. You know, when you go to church, it's all about money. You know, and when you tell your children it is all about money, you tell them, you know, you are witnessing negatively. May God help you to give life to your family by witnessing the goodness of this kingdom. Hallelujah. Number four, a woman is a widow. 2 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 5. Watch out, one video utakuwa kio, ama dirisha, a widow to see through. A woman is a widow to see through. Ebuskia hii. I'm reminded of your sincere faith. This is Paul talking to Timothy, which first lived in your grandmother Lois and your mother Eunice. Timothy is drawing faith from these two women, the grandmother and the mother. And so it is good to ask yourself, am I a widow? Am I a person that you can portray Jesus, who can portray positivity, who can portray life and even light to my people, because you are the window to see through. Praise be to God. And lastly, and that's where now I'll build my few minutes I'm from, a woman is a worshiper. A woman is a worshiper. That is Jeremiah chapter 9 and verse 20. Jeremiah 9, verse 20. Now you women, hear the word of the Lord. Open your ears to the words of his mouth. Teach your daughters how chapter, it should be chapter 2, verse number 36. It talks about another woman who was called Anna. Anna, she lived with her husband only for 7 years. And after that, she went into the temple and lived there, praising and worshiping God. And the Bible says that she was there until Jesus was revealed. And then Jesus came in the temple. When she welcomed Jesus, then she said, now she can go. Why? She remained there to be a worshiper, pushing forth the purposes of God. Woman, you are there in your family, in a church like this, in the society. Can you push forth the purposes of God through prayer? Because you are a worshiper. That brings me to our first reading, 2 Kings chapter number 4 from verse 8. The Bible talks about a Shunammite woman, a Shunammite woman. And the Bible says, this Shunammite woman, she saw Elisha passing by. Let me tell you this, that women, we are always told they have got sixth sense. But when we come to spiritual matters, I would say they have this discernment. All of us, because woman, on the other hand, it represents the church. Now men, come on board. Hallelujah. Men, hello. Yes, come on board now. Woman in the Bible represents the church. So all of us, we need discerning spirit, because Elisha could have passed like any other man, but it took a woman with discernment to know it is not an ordinary man, but it is a holy man of God. And the Bible says she could welcome her in her house and she could take meal and leave. It takes generosity to welcome him. Hallelujah. It takes generosity to welcome him. And that's why, because women, when you are mama, kisema utakula huko, hata kama chakula hiko, wezi kula. So, imagine how God has privileged you, that you are the one to entertain visitors, to entertain such a holy man of God. And in our case today, I want us to see Elisha as the heavenlies, as our God. The Bible says in our second reading, second Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 2, that make a room for us. Make a room for us. Paul is talking to Corinthians and he's telling them, make a room for us. Now this morning, I want you to see it as the Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, God the Spirit, telling you, make a room for us. Accommodate us in you. And this is what the woman did. The Bible says, after some time, giving Elisha food, coming and going, she decided to take it to a higher level. And this is my climax. And this is where I'm at in Givers, verse 10. The Bible says, she approached the husband. And she told the husband, this man is a holy man of God. This man who comes here to take meal and go, he is a holy man of God. Can we make a room for him? It is not easy, especially to a man like me. My wife coming and telling me now, I've seen a man, a holy man of God. And I'll try to accommodate him in our house. Praise be to God. Yes, but I rely on God, because I tell women, there is power in women. You know, and God has given you this power. Anything that you want from man, God has given you that wisdom to get it. So she knew how to approach the husband. She knew how to do it. And the Bible says, finally, the husband gave in. But it was not over, because she is saying, let us make him a room here. The woman goes further and he says, now I'm getting deep. The Bible says, let us make him an upper room. If we are to accommodate the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit in our lives, they must take the priority in our lives. They must take the priority. The Bible is talking about the upper room. When the husband was told, we want to accommodate Elisha here, maybe he thought in one of our guest rooms, in one of the rooms that are not busy, in one of the rooms of our daughters who is in boarding. No, and the woman is very specific. up in the morning and you start with prayer, if you don't pray every morning, if you don't pray before you sleep, then God has not taken priority in your home. If you don't even bless food, you know, giving thanks for food. If you don't pray with your husband, with your children, if you don't do that, if you don't have a family altar, wherever you read word and pray and give thanks before you sleep, then God is not number one in your family. And women, because it is your day, and you have told woman is a mother of life, go and start that. Men, you are the priest in the house, go and make God number one in your family. Before you start wondering, what shall we do because of this and that, always start with God. Start with prayer. Why? God should take the upper room in our lives. If God is your number one, you can never afford to come late. Why? He is your number one. Every time in church, we are praying, and even today we pray, God, to them that are coming, God, fasten your feet. God, hasten your feet. Kila siku unapewa hapa miguu yako ishike moto. Sisi itawaka siku moto. May God help you to give God number one. I've never seen a boss somewhere praying for him, his workers or her workers. Oh God, I pray. The workers that are about to come. Praise be to God. The workers that are about to come so that you can work today. It is my prayer that my Father, you may hasten your feet. Wapi? You are going to lose your job. But our God is so merciful. But let us not take it for granted. May God help you to give God an upper room. Praise be to God. Number two, the Bible says that they were told to put a bed in that room. Bed means comfort. Can you give God comfort in your home? Is God comfortable in your home? You know, sometimes we may welcome God, we may invite God, but all the same, we find ourselves that he's not comfortable. Why? We have our own schemes and our own doings that we do, you know, behind him. Can we accommodate God with no other things that are attached? Praise be to God. The other thing they say, they put a table, that is a working field. Give God a working field in your home. Let God take the wheel. Let him work for you. You are work in progress. Your family is work in progress. Give a table for him. The other one, it is a chair. Chair means leadership. Let God take chairmanship. Let him be a leader. Let him be the one that you consult, the one who signs everything, the one who gives go ahead of everything that you want to do. Give him a seat. And the other one, which is the last one, the Bible says they put a lamp for him. Let there be transparency. Be transparent with each other. Let there be no darkness in that home. Let there be no fishy things around that may hinder the move of God. So this morning, as you come to conclusion, may God help you to accommodate him in the upper room. Make him comfortable by that bed. Give him working field with that table. Give him leadership with that chair. And do away with every darkness so that you can be transparent with each other, so that God can be accommodated in our lives. Let us pray. Our dear Lord, we are grateful. Thank you for that because of me so good to us. Thank you because of your love and care and protection. Thank you because of reminding us that women are the mother of life. Thank you because of reminding us all that we need to do to accommodate you. It is my prayer that from today we shall accommodate you in our lives, accommodate you in our homes, accommodate you in our villages, in our churches, in our working places, all to the glory and honor of your holy name. We pray this believing and trusting in Jesus.
Thank you for the leaders of this morning service. And now the Lord bless you and keep you. Our Lord make you his face to shine upon you. And be gracious to you. The Lord and kindly on you and give you peace. And the blessing of our God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Amen. Fika mwisho, kusikia kwamba utakuwa ibada ingine ya pili. Nzuri. Kwa hivyo, asanteni Bwana, bariki sana. Oh.